protons and neutrons are inside the nucleus in the middle, while the electrons orbit on the outermost layers on the outside.
Without the scientists in the past, clearly we wouldn't understand atomic particles. So let's take a look back at the science timeline. In the Greek era, Democritus thought all the matter was made of small particles that can't be divided. These particles are called atoms. Next came along Aristotle. He thought that there were no limit to the number of times matter could be divided. Fast forward to 1704, Isaac Newton from England came along. He created the laws of motion in science. Next is John Dalton. In 1805, he discovered the atomic theory. He also believed that atoms were indivisible. In 1869, Dmitri Mendeleev arranged elements with similar properties in seven groups. This is now known as the periodic law. In 1894, G.J. Stoney thought electricity was made of negative particles called electrons. J.J. Thompson thought there were positive and negative charges in 1897. Then there's Ernest Rutherford. He did the gold foil experiment in 1911 and realized there's positive charges in the nucleus and electrons were on the outside. H.G.J. Mosley discovered the atomic number is equal to the number of protons. Finally, in 1922, Niels Bohr stated that electrons orbit around the positive nucleus.
We will now be discussing the two different models from Bohr and Lewis. Here's Bohr's.
Only two electrons can be on the first ring, then so on until you reach the number you need for electrons on the outer rings. The outer layer is the valence area. This area contains the valence electrons.
You only need to draw the valence electrons around the element symbol. Here's an example of Lewis's model. In the previous picture, there were four valence electrons around the outer rings, so you would draw four dots around the element symbol. And here's an example of Lewis's model.
So today, I'm going to be talking about adding and taking away. For example, we use carbon. The mass is 12, the proton is 6, and the neutron is 6. How do we got that is this formula, which is neutrons equal to mass subtract. So, let me tell you this for a fact. So if you have one less proton, you have boron. And if you have one more proton, guess what? You got nitrogen. Now let's take a look at the periodic table.
As you see here, to the left of carbon is boron when you take away one proton, and to the right of carbon is nitrogen when you add one proton.
So back to the chart. Whenever you have one less neutron, you have carbon 11. And whenever we have one more neutron, you have carbon 13. So basically the only thing that happens is the mass changes. Whenever you have one less electron, you have cation, which is metals. Whenever you have one more electron, you have anion, which is nonmetal. And this is the lesson of the day.
There's antimony, arsenic, aluminum, selenium, and hydrogen, and oxygen, and nitrogen, and rhenium, and nickel, neodymium, neptunium, germanium, and iron, americium, ruthenium, uranium, europium, zirconium, lutetium, vanadium, and lanthanum, and osmium, and astatine, and radium, and gold, and protactinium, and indium, and gallium, and iodine, and thorium, and thulium, and thallium. There's yttrium, ytterbium, actinium, rubidium, and boron, gadolinium, niobium, iridium, and strontium, and silicon, and silver, and samarium, and bismuth, bromine, lithium, beryllium, and barium. There's holmium and helium and hafnium and erbium and phosphorus and francium and fluorine and terbium and manganese and mercury, molybdenum, magnesium, dysprosium and scandium and cerium and cesium and lead, praseodymium and platinum, plutonium, palladium, promethium, potassium, polonium and tantalum, technetium, titanium, tellurium and cadmium and calcium and chromium and curium. There's sulfur, californium, and fermium, berkelium, and also mendelevium, einsteinium, nobelium, and argon, krypton, neon, radon, xenon, zinc, and rhodium, and chlorine, carbon, cobalt, copper, tungsten, tin, and sodium. These are the only ones of which the news has come to Harvard. And there may be many others, but they haven't been discovered.
The alkali metals are lithium, sodium, potassium, rubidium, cesium, and francium in the orange. And the royal blue is the alkaline earth metals, which is beryllium, magnesium, calcium, strontium, barium, and radium. Over to the right is the boron family. Boron, aluminum, gallium, indium, and thallium are the elements that make up that family. In the carbon family, there are carbon, silicon, germanium, tin, and lead. In the nitrogen family, there is nitrogen, phosphorus, arsenic, antimony, and bismuth. In the oxygen family, there are oxygen, sulfur, selenium, tellurium, and polonium. The halogens are fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, and actinide. And last but not least are the noble gases, which are helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, and radon. And these are the periodic table of elements families.
This is our concept map for the four families of the periodic table. Alkaline metals has one electron in the valence area, and it reacts with the nonmetals. Next is alkaline earth metals. It has two electrons in the valence area, and it loses electrons to make cations. Next is halogen. It has seven valence electrons. It goes from liquids to gas. It reacts with the alkaline earth metals and the alkaline metals. Last is noble gases. It's non-reactive and has a complete valence area. Its boiling point is low.
The alkaline metals are in red, the alkaline earth metals are in orange, the halogens are in light blue, and the noble gases are in dark blue. Next are the metals. They look shiny and metallic, they're solid, and they are good thermal and electrical conductors. Last but not least are the metalloids. They have the characteristics of metals and nonmetals, and their reactivity depends on other metals. The yellow group is a nonmetal group. The yellow area is a transition metals area. The circled area are the metalloids. The red areas show the metals on the periodic table. The columns go straight down. The rows go straight across. The atomic number on the top right corner. The different groups are shown. The quantum numbers on the left side.
This is how we do it.
Periodic table.
It's good, good.
Periodic table. Periodic table. Periodic table.
This is how we do it. It's Monday morning. Fucking physical science class. Learn about atomic mass. Then we learn about the atomic number and go all the way down. Learn about the element symbol. The element symbol goes with its name. C equals carbon, know what I'm saying. Then got a different families, man. Boron, carbon, nitrogen. Don't forget about the big old oxygen. You know what I'm saying, man.